being with us. I'm very, very excited to present the Accidentals today. I saw them at Folk Alliance, and they are going to be playing the festival, and that was an amazing setup in 5 minutes. And so I don't want to take any more of their time. Please welcome the Accidentals. Woo!
That you guys are here and that we're here in the same spot. This next song is a song that I wrote in a bathroom stall, actually. Just the melody. I had this melody stuck in my head and it was just there on repeat, and I knew it was gonna leave the moment I did, so I did what was natural and sang it into my iPhone. And when I came out, there was a lady standing on the other side and she was just staring at me. It was really awkward. And then she said, "What song is that?" I said, "I don't know." So I took it home and ended up writing a song about commercialism and kind of trying to stay true to yourself in a world pulling you in 20 billion different directions. It's called Epitaphs.
Too much.
guys. So raise your hand if you consider yourself a nerd. Yeah, us too. We're super nerdy, actually. Our idea of a party is we sit around and watch black and white movies and eat shell mac and cheese, and maybe there's a cat in the mix, who knows. Gets pretty crazy, but we actually, when we're on the road, we spend most of our time reading books and then writing songs about these books, so that's where this next song comes from. I read a book called House of Tomorrow by Peter Brognani, and I'm going to quickly sum it up in footnotes. It's about this boy who lives in a glass tourist attraction dome with his psychotic grandmother who doesn't let him have a social life, so he runs away and makes friends with a punk rocker kid with a heart defect. And the punk rocker kid with a heart defect tells him that Napoleon was the first punk rocker. So I decided to write a song about that. Eventually I had this song, and my parents were really encouraging me to share it with the author who had inspired it, but I was kind of pushing against that because I considered the song basic plagiarism at that point. And I remember my mom turned to me, I was 16 years old, she's like, "Oh honey, all art is plagiarism." Which is really comforting to hear as a budding artist. All art is plagiarism, but it's true. It's good plagiarism though, it's inspiration. So, yes, now that the story is sufficiently longer than the song, this song is called Bulletproof Glass. Song is a song we wrote about college applications. It's called The End. Yeah. so much for having us. We got time to squeeze in one more song, I think. Oh, cool. We got a special guest on this song. We have one of our all-time favorite guitarists has been on tour with us down to South by Southwest and back. His name's Jake Allen. Please make some noise. We're going to play a song that we composed. It's an instrumental that'll be on our upcoming album. It'll be out later this summer, and we're happy to say that Sony Masterworks is going to be distributing it worldwide. Yeah. This one's called Ballad Tender Gun.
Thank you.
Before you catch us at our other showcase, we'll see you at South by.